killing the genocidal U.S. energy policy with violence that is violating the property, violating the rights of others. Violating even the assumed rights of others, if before God they're not rights, is certain and utter defeat, is certain and utter killing of time and nothing more. Insanity. Derek Jensen's been interviewed on Democracy Now! Several times, and there are other videos of his online. He brings to us a wonderful understanding of at the visceral level the desecration of Mother Earth, the evisceration of Mother Earth, the mutilation of Mother Earth, on which we entirely and totally depend for our existence. Tragically, his life has been one of loveless violence visited on him, as I understand he relates his life. Tragically for him, and it could be for us if we're not careful, he has no understanding of the power of love as a weapon 1 trillion times more powerful than the weapons of violence and hate and anger. This must be avoided. His lead must be avoided at all costs. He brings a rare sense that what currently is being done in so-called activism is a joke. For that needs to be commended. But just as he was brought up, seeing only one course of action, violence, that must be totally rejected. What greater example could we have than our brothers and sisters in Egypt, with their near pure nonviolence in the face of incredible brutality? Look at how, in a matter of hours, they unleashed international support, worldwide support behind their effort. Every bit of violence will stave off such a global solidarity for years or decades, years and decades that we don't have. This must be avoided. This stupidity must be avoided. We don't have time for angry rants. We don't have time for token efforts. We don't have time for symbolic efforts. We have time, as Thich Nhat Hanh said, to unleash the power of love. The force of Gandhi, the force of King, the force of Nelson Mandela, the force of the Egyptian revolutionaries, the force of Stephen Biko, the force of Rachel Corrie, the force of Eleanor Roosevelt. Let's get on with it. A war, a genocide is being waged on your immediate family, your children, your grandchildren. And soon it'll be over unless you enter the fight. Fighting to the death as they are, with massively courageous, all-out anti-violence, all-out waging love, all-out waging humanity, all-out totally pitting your heart against the murderous, blind, insane hordes corporate America, especially the coal and oil industry, that as the blind, insane addicts that they are, bear you no malice, and their insanity is utterly destroying the ability of Earth to support human life, utterly destroying the ability of Earth to have an economy, with the most definitive study indicating that by mid-century, if we don't immediately kill carbon, kill our carbon policy, reduce carbon 80% by 2020, that by mid-century, your children's global economy will have been crushed, being a mere 70% of its otherwise potential value. A mere 2% of GDP spent now will avert a 30% collapse by mid-century. What are you waiting for?